We want to write the given number using Roman numerals. The basic Roman numeral symbols are given here with their corresponding values. We can combine these symbols to represent the given numbers using Roman numerals. So for a quick review, numbers are formed by combining the symbols together. If the numbers are placed from left to right in order of value, starting with the largest value, followed by the smaller values, the values are added as we see here. The two X's represent 20, the V represents 5, the three I's represent 3. 20 plus 5 plus 3 equals 28. However, to avoid repeated characters, if a smaller numeral comes before a larger numeral, the smaller is subtracted from the larger. So for example, instead of using 4 capital I's for 4, we put an I before a V, or a 1 before a 5. This represents 5 minus 1, or 4. For 997, notice how we have a C before an M. This is a 100 before a 1,000. This represents 1,000 minus 100, or 900, followed by an X before a C, or a 10 before a 100. 100 minus 10 is 90, followed by 5 plus 1 plus 1, or plus 7, for 997. This subtraction principle can be a little involved because there are restrictions. You can only subtract a power of 10, and only from the next two higher digits, where the digits are the symbols given here, which means only I, X, and C can be subtracted, and I can only be subtracted from V and X. X can only be subtracted from L and C can be subtracted only from D and M. Let's go back and look at our examples. For 56, notice how we can use L for 50, and then for 6, we can use a V and a capital I, where the V would come first, followed by the I. This would be 50 plus 6, or 56. For 187, we can use a C for 100. Now for 80, we can use an L, followed by three X's. So there's 50 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10, or 80. And then for 7, we can use a V and two I's. Because we have the largest values first, followed by the smaller values, we add all the values, giving us 187. Now for the next three, we'll have to use the subtraction principle. For example, for 400, we can't use four C's because we have to avoid repeating four symbols. So what we can do is put a C before a D, which would be a 100 before a 500, meaning we would subtract. So if we have C and then D, this represents 400 because this is 500 minus 100. And then for 20, we can use two X's. But for 9, we can't use a V and four I's. We'll have to use a subtraction principle. If we put an I before an X, that's like putting a 1 before a 10, meaning we subtract. 10 minus 1 is 9. So we'll have I and then X. Again, this is 400, this is 20, and this is 9. For 949, we'll start with 900. Using the subtraction principle, we'll put a 100 before a 1,000, or a C before an M. So there's 900. And then for 40, we cannot use four X's because we cannot repeat four symbols. So we'll use a 10 before a 50, or an X before an L. And then for 9, again, we'll use an I before an X, or a 1 before a 10. So here we have 900, here we have 40, and here we have 9. Finally, for 2,994, we'll start with a 2,000, which is two M's. Now for 900, again, we'll have to use a 100 before a 1,000, or a C before an M, meaning we'll subtract 100 from a 1,000 to get 900. And then for 90, we'll have to use the subtraction principle and put a 10 before a 100, or an X before a C. So there's the 90. And finally for 4, we can't use four I's. We'll have to use an I before a V, or a 1 before a 5, so we subtract. So we have I and then V. So we have 2,994. 94. I hope you found this helpful.